you know, an expensive shoe buyer like yourself,
yeah,
you know, it really matters to make sure you've got the authentic shoes you you anticipated getting.
Hello, I'm Rob Armstrong, Chief Marketing Officer here at Zebra Technologies. Welcome to Better Conversations, a new video series where I'll speak with leading executives, customers, and partners about the trends, innovations, and insights that highlight how the latest technologies are improving both frontline operations and everyday life. To kick things off, we're going to walk through the journey that a pair of shoes follows from the factory floor to your front door. Joining me for today's conversation is Tom Bianculli, the Chief Technology Officer here at Zebra. Tom, thanks for joining me.
Great to be here, Rob. Thanks for having me.
Are you a sneakerhead?
You know, I've been known to be a bit of a sneaker aficionado.
All right, well, you're very official looking today. So let's jump right in.
Yeah.
We think about a pair of shoes from the factory where it's made to the front door where it's probably being delivered.
Yep.
How many times do you think a Zebra product or solution or a worker using a Zebra product or solution is actually touching that pair of shoes?
You know, if you break it down, Rob, you figure it's probably being moved into five or six different facilities. So from the manufacturer out to finished goods, into a distribution center, into retail, out to last mile, there's five right there. And then each one of those points, it's probably touched about five times. So if you think about six stops along the supply chain, touching it five times at each one,
carry the one.
Yeah, exactly.
30.
30, yeah,
there
about 30 times.
Let's start at the very beginning of that journey. What are some of the ways that manufacturers are using technology now to improve their production process?
Certainly automation's playing a huge role in that.
Yep.
But in particular, areas like machine vision, like our acquisition of Photoneo, new capabilities that can do 3D inspection, it can do it at speed in real time. So we're gonna be looking at the soles, the laces, the tongue of that shoe, really ensure that it was produced the right way. Second one would be using AI to do predictive detection of variances in a process. And so being able to pick up on those hints and then preemptively trigger an event that could prevent the downtime in that facility.
Okay, so we've made the pair of shoes.
Yeah.
Now I gotta get it somewhere. That next step of the journey, what type of technology and solutions are being used there?
RFID, RFID, and RFID. I mean, whether it's fixed infrastructure, it's handheld RFID, we're seeing that being used to track, say, the ingestion at a pallet level, and at a carton level as well, maybe from a picking or a pallet breakdown point of view using a handheld device. And then serialization, which RFID supports, but also GS1 Digital Link supports as well from a barcode perspective, but particularly in the shoe and sneaker space,
counterfeit.
You know, about 12%, it's estimated, of counterfeit goods are actually from shoe wear. It's about a $500 million problem out of the total $4 trillion counterfeit market.
Wow.
Really a big one that serialization can help mitigate.
Okay, let's say I'm in a distribution center somewhere for order fulfillment. Like what technologies are being used there now?
If you think about taking the connected worker with wearable technology, combining that with software intelligence that can orchestrate in the environment and then bring robots in for collaborative picking.
I knew you were gonna get robots in at some point.
I had to get in there somewhere. I'm surprised it took me this long.
Yeah.
But yeah. So being able to use cobots that are collaborative robots that interoperate with people in that facility. We have some software we call Symmetry that can orchestrate the picking of those shoes within the warehouse. So the robots are kind of making their way to the right location, telling the person what to pick. They're picking it, loading it onto the robot, and then it's taking it out to the packout station where it gets shipped.
But let's say I'm a retailer.
Yes.
And I get, how do you buy your shoes?
Usually online these days.
Okay, I thought you were gonna say that. So let's say that you're buying online.
Right.
A lot of times it's not actually gonna be fulfilled by a central warehouse. It's gonna actually be picked and filled by a nearby store. What are the things that a retailer is doing to fulfill that e-commerce order?
We're seeing more and more warehouse technology trickle down into the store. So if you think about those wearables I was mentioning earlier, those are being deployed in the front of the store to do that picking. When you look at a distribution center, they're sitting at about 99% inventory accuracy, but stores are at about 65%. So if you're gonna fulfill from that store, it becomes really critical to make sure you've got much higher inventory accuracy so you don't promise them something that ultimately you can't deliver.
And if they now actually have it, and now they're gonna deliver it to the home, what type of technology are being used from the store to your front
door? Yeah, so that last mile delivery aspect is the most expensive part of the delivery across the whole supply chain. Yeah, it's that last mile because it's one of the most, it's one of the most labor intensive. So you think about loading that vehicle, then you're stopping at every individual house. So you have really no bulk operation going on at that point.
Right.
So you know, using technology that allows the loaders of those vehicles to make sure they're packages are getting put in the right order to follow the delivery route. And then when you actually get to the stops, being able to find those packages quickly, everything from RFID to computer vision, actually on some of our handheld devices, and then really automating the whole proof of delivery process. Using AI, you can just snap one picture, it'll read the barcode, take the picture, automatically populate where it was dropped. Like the AI can understand
like
the differences.
Like front door, garage.
Exactly. You know, you start saving a few seconds per delivery, and it adds up.
Okay, so you walked me through from the point of manufacture to now your front door.
Yeah.
When you take a step back as a CTO, what's the coolest part of that journey?
The most exciting part for me is the incremental improvements from each one of those areas, because when you look at the compound effects of that, it's way bigger than, you know, the risk associated with making a much bigger transformational investment.
On one step.
Exactly. Yeah. And that resonates very much with our customers as well.
I mean, like you said, the aggregate impact is pretty incredible.
It really is.
Awesome.
The rate at which technology is changing, there's more and more opportunities for those incremental improvements every day.
Thanks, Tom, for being with me.
Thanks, Rob.
Hopefully the time with Tom today helps illustrate the fact that Zebra plays a critical role in helping businesses across the supply chain operate their front line with more intelligence. Whether it's improving quality, enhancing productivity, increasing accuracy, or working with our customers to improve their customer experiences, Zebra creates new ways of working that make everyday life better. Thank you, and I look forward to our next Better Conversation.